The US Air Force B-52 Stratofortress bomber has conducted the first ever launch of laser-guided bombs from a new conventional rotary launcher, CRL. CRL is a rotating carriage system that enables long-range bombers like B-52 to carry different kinds of ammunition inside the bomb bay. This could be used to deploy air-launched cruise missiles and guided and unguided conventional as well as nuclear bombs. According to a 307th Bomb Wing report, the test was performed by the 49th Test and Evaluation Squadron on August 28, 2019. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how conventional rotary launcher, CRL, will make B-52 Stratofortress more lethal. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game, War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support, so grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. The Boeing B-52 Stratofortress is an American long-range, subsonic, jet-powered strategic bomber. The B-52 was designed and built by Boeing, which has continued to provide support and upgrades. It's been operated by the United States Air Force, USAF, since the 1950s. Superior performance at high subsonic speeds and relatively low operating costs have kept the B-52 in service despite the advent of more advanced aircraft, including the variable geometry B-1B Lancer and the stealth B-2 Spirit. B-52 Stratofortress replaced the Convair B-36, and it was meant to carry nuclear weapons for Cold War-era deterrence missions. It's a veteran of several wars, which includes Vietnam War. Interestingly, the B-52's official name, Stratofortress, is rarely used. Informally, the aircraft has become commonly known as the BUF, Big Ugly Fat Fucker, or Fella. B-52 is powered by Pratt & Whitney TF-33 P3-103 turbofans. The 8 engines of the B-52 are paired in pods and suspended by 4 pylons beneath and forward of the wing's leading edge. Each generates 17,000 pound force, 76 kilonewtons of thrust. It has a typical combat range of more than 8,800 miles, that's 14,080 kilometers, without aerial refueling. The massive range enables B-52 to take on strategic bombing missions. The powerful engines also enable B-52 to carry up to 70,000 pounds, that's 32,000 kilograms, of weapons, making it one of the most destructive bombers in the world. The B-52 is capable of carrying both conventional as well as nuclear weapons. They include free-fall bombs like CBU-87, air-launched cruise missiles like AGM-86s, and laser-guided bombs like GBU-10, GBU-12, and GBU-28. Sometime back, laser-guided bomb LGB were deployed from the bomb bay of the jet using a cluster bomb rack system, but certain analysis indicated that the method could have adverse safety implications and the practice was discontinued. So LGB had to be carried externally, which is not the best solution. Lieutenant Colonel Joseph Little, 49th TES Commander, explained, "We've still been able to utilize LGBs underneath the wings of the B-52, but they don't do very well when carried externally because they're susceptible to icing and other weather conditions." According to him, the seeker head of the LGB can be adversely affected by the elements, potentially reducing its effectiveness. This is where conventional rotary launcher comes in. It's an alternative to the cluster bomb rack system and has no safety issues. With CRL, the bombs could be carried internally without exposing them to the harmful effects of the weather. The CRL is basically a weapon carrying and deployment system designed for the B-52 that enables it to carry a variety of munitions. It was made available to the B-52 fleet in 2017. However, it was limited to supplying power to only 4 munitions at a time. Major Jason McCarger, a 49th Test and Evaluation Squadron Unit Project Officer, explained, "The conventional rotary launcher has a high power draw, so an aircrew could only power up 4 munitions at a time without risking blowing circuit breakers in mid-flight." He added, "With this upgrade, it can now have 8 ready at once." Lieutenant Colonel Joseph Little said, "It's another arrow in the quiver. It gives us the ability to carry more LGBs on the aircraft or give more variation on a conventional load. It adds capability and is another thing you can bring to the fight." Senior Master Sergeant Michael Pierce, 307th Maintenance Squadron Aircraft Armament Superintendent, who was part of the effort to bring the CRL online at Barksdale AFB in 2017, said the ability to carry a full power load to all munitions on the CRL, in addition to another 12 under the B-52's wings, has the potential to improve the jet's lethality in combat. He explained, "Now a B-52 going into a war zone has the ability to put 20 munitions on a target area very quickly. Before, they would have to drop some of their munitions, power up the CRL again, and then make another pass." He added, "The entire effort to modify the CRL moved pretty quickly. The bottom line is, yesterday we had the capability to deliver 16 weapons at one time, and today we can deliver 20 of them. CRL was not originally designed for gravity-type bombs like the LGB. The software upgrades have enabled this." It's to be noted that apart from being enabled to deliver more munitions in less time, the modified CRL has greater payloads for specific types of weapons. During the test, 8 AGM-158 joint air-to-surface standoff missiles were deployed on the CRL as part of the testing. This has special significance. The AGM-158 JASSM joint air-to-surface standoff missile is a low observable standoff air-launched cruise missile developed by Lockheed Martin for the United States Armed Forces. It's a large, stealthy, long-range weapon with a 1,000-pound, that's 454-kilogram, armor-piercing warhead, and went into service in 2009. An extended-range version of the missile, the AGM-158B JASSM-ER, Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missile, Extended Range, entered service in 2014. B-52 is not a stealth aircraft, and it has high radar returns, making it vulnerable. AGM-158 JASSM and AGM-158B JASSM-ER enables it to strike targets without having to get into enemy strike envelope. JASSM's range is about 230 miles. Or 370 kilometers, whereas JASSM-ER has a range of 575 miles, 925 kilometers. Though B-52s are old, they still have a role today. Its enormous payload capacity and long range gives the American Air Force tremendous operational flexibility. The US Air Force is now developing the first prototype of the new B-21 Raider bomber. The B-21 Raider is envisaged to be a super stealthy bomber which will be able to penetrate the most sophisticated air defenses for decades into the future and be able to take out high-value enemy targets without the rival even knowing it was there in the first place. Though some B-52s will be replaced by Raiders, some will remain active to complement the B-21s going forward, and this will see them operating beyond 2045. There are also some proposals to extend the life of B-52 till 2060 with engine update. In this situation, updates like CRL make sense, as it will enhance a platform which is already widely used by the US Air Force.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.